Coach Farouk, thank you very much for the opportunity. Your boys just won the game comfortably 2-0. Could have been more. How did you view the game?
Well, I think we're in a building stage at this moment. We lost quite a number of players. Some have been able to go to America on scholarships. We've got some of the players that have been promoted to PSL teams. So we have only about 3 or 4 from last season's team that finished second. And it's a building process, but it allows us to bring some of the younger boys from the under-17s, under-15s into the team. And I think that is very good for development when the older boys leave spaces for the younger guys to come and stake their claim. So it's exciting times. It's not easy. It's not yet where we want to be. But then again, in development, you know, you're constantly evolving and you're constantly trying to improve.
Okay. Coach, you are in the men's regional league. You've been there for a while. What is your view of the standard of the league, and in terms of your dedication to development, do you think it offers you the platform to further develop these players?
Well, I think it's been different from season to season. We have had some very good teams last season that played in this league, and we have clubs like Orlando Pirates and several other clubs. The Chiefs had a team in this league as well at one stage. They don't have any. So from season to season it changes, but because it's a league where you can play older players, it offers us an opportunity to take our younger players and play them against more experienced, more matured, more physically developed players. And that is what we need, because our whole aim is not to get promoted to the Motsepe League. Our aim is to use this platform to give these youngsters an opportunity to have competition. Competition is extremely important, and I think in South Africa we need to improve the level of competition in all areas, not only in the Castle or Motsepe League, but also in the junior leagues, because from week in and week out our younger boys are winning by huge margins in the LFAs, and that's not what we want. We want leagues where we can compete, and it will force us out of our comfort zone and force us to improve so that these boys can eventually become top professionals.
Coach, you've just spoken, touched on development. We know you've been in development for a very, very long time. You've developed many players, and I think you are one of the best people to answer this question of where are we in terms of our development? Are we on the right track? Are we doing things right, or we seem to be stuck?
Well, I think there's still lots of room for improvement. I think there is development taking place in little pockets, in clubs, in professional clubs. They have very good structures there. We have the Diski League in the PSL, which I think is a fantastic initiative that was brought about by the PSL hierarchy. And I think that offers us the opportunity to take our development to the next level. However, I believe that development should basically start at schools where development is non-existent. There is sometimes competitions like the Motsepe League, etc., but we're not doing enough. So I do believe that from as early as 5 and 6 years old, the fundamentals should be taught. Kids should learn how to do the basics, and they should grow up, because football is more about technique from a younger age, and tactics is informed later on in their career. So I do think there is lots of improvement needed at both boys and girls football at school level. Then in the LFAs as well, I think we can do better. I think the leagues are not as strong as we'd like them to be. If you look at models around the world, their LFAs and their schools football is very strong. And that allows them to have a very strong foundation. And ultimately that would interpret into completely developed, rounded professional players. We still find, even with some of our professional players, they still have certain deficiencies and lack in certain areas. And that is as a consequence of poor development at grassroots level.
Very informative, Coach. Coach, obviously you develop players so that they can move on to big teams, to professional level. But we also understand that the pressure at that level sometimes means that coaches do not introduce these players. In your view, how can that be handled in terms of making sure that the players that are developed are ready for first team football, and also the coaches are more welcoming to introducing these youngsters?
Well, I think to be fair to the coaches as such, if those players are well developed and well rounded, there's no coach in the world. I often hear people saying that these players are well developed players at the professional teams. In fact, there's teams that are saying these boys should be playing. I don't think that is very accurate, because no coach will leave out a player once he's fully developed, because a coach wants to use his best players. I think the problem is that expectations at a top level is such where coaches are forced to play their best players, and if it means that their best players are the likes of Jabu Pule, Tlantla Kubeka, Isaac Mabotsa, Gerald Sibeko. I'm mentioning these players because when I promoted them at Chiefs, they all played regularly. So I think that is the key, that if we at grassroots level do what is necessary and ensure that the players are well-rounded, then obviously those players will be welcomed by any coach to play in the first team.
Coach, we have a new coach, international team. He's come in and immediately brought in younger players. What do you think that does for our football, and what message does it send to teams as well in terms of giving young players a chance?
I think it's a very positive initiative from the coach Bruce, and I think we need to support those initiatives, and we need to ensure that we give him the necessary support coming to the national team when it comes to ensuring that these younger players get the exposure, and then him obviously using these players ultimately in the national team. One thing I do want to advise on is the fact that you need to blend these younger players with experience. I think if you only have younger players in the team, you are probably going to have problems moving forward when you play the stronger teams, like now we're going to play Ghana and Zimbabwe. We shouldn't underestimate those teams, because yes, we beat Ethiopia, but then again, that's not a true indication. The likes of Percy Tau, the likes of Rivaldo Kutsia, the likes of Zwane, they should be involved and they should be brought into this team so that they can give the necessary experience. What I'm saying is there needs to be a balance between your experience and your youth to ensure that we move on and qualify for the World Cup.
Coach, before I let you go, I know coaches don't like to speak about individual players, but I have to mention the young man, number 25, Sean. When did he come to you guys, and what do you think of his development?
Well, it seems like you have a very good eye for talent. I mean, you've spotted a brilliant player there. And this is the other problem. We don't have enough scouts to see what you see to see him today. Sean is now turning 21. He's been with us for the last 7 years. He's an extremely good player. He's a player that I think can fit into any professional setup. But obviously, you know, we need people to come and scout him. And we need to ensure that these scouts then go back to their clubs and say, look, there is a diamond at Stars of Africa that hasn't been claimed by anybody. Let's go and get him. And in the next 2 or 3 years, I think Sean could be one of the best attacking midfielders in the country. He's also very versatile. He can play as a left back. He can play as a center back. So his versatility could also help tremendously. I think if you look at some of the players that we have now in the PSL, like Kabelo Dlamini, Brendan Theron, Junaid Said, you've got Nyama there. I mean, there's quite a few boys that haven't disappointed. So I think he's in the same cut. He's a player that can make his impact in the PSL. And I think, you know, like you spotted him, surely they would see his quality.
Coach, thank you very much for the opportunity and all the best.
Thank you very much. Thank